So customers from every industry and of every size of company have turned to AppDynamics to help make sure that their modern distributed architectures continue to perform well and work to deliver the kind of experiences their customers are demanding. You have our commitment that we will continue to aggressively invest in this part of our stack, the visibility that we provide you over the years ahead. But over the last couple of years, as I mentioned earlier, we've also taken the data and the correlation of that data from that best-of-breed visibility platform, and we fed it into the brand new AI/ML engine that we've been working on. So with that, I'm thrilled to announce our all-new Cognition Engine. The Cognition Engine gets data from that end-to-end visibility platform and identifies the anomalies that are forming and suggests the likely root cause without any configuration on your part. All of that insight can then be used to set up policies to automate the appropriate actions, like open a smarter ticket, or kill a bad instance of a microservice, or provision more virtual machines. So to show you what we've done here, I'm thrilled to welcome up Eli Greenfield, VP of our Platform Engineering and Operations. Eli?
Hey, David. How are you?
Good. Super excited, actually, to be showing off what we're doing with the Cognition Engine and some of the investments that we're making into more of the insights and actioning pillars in the product. So to do that, I've got a brand new, fresh out of the box installation of AppDynamics here that is looking at what is sort of a typical customer environment. Now, this one is probably a lot smaller and simpler than what a lot of our customers see. But even so, all is not well in Denmark here, right? Our customers are happily sleeping. But if you look down at these two charts at the bottom here, you can see that the load on the application is starting to drop while the response time is starting to go up. That's not a good combination. Right? So now normally, if this wasn't a fresh installation, we'd have done some configuration on AppDynamics, and we'd have set up some health rules, and a bunch of these tiers that we're seeing on the flow map here would be turning up red. And our application team, our ops team, would be getting woken up in the middle of the night, and they'd come to AppDynamics, and they'd start poking around through all the areas they see and you know, trying to understand the problem and figure out which of those are relevant and which ones aren't. But in this case, even though this is fresh out of the box, because we've got the new Cognition Engine in there, from day one, it's watching the application, watching the data coming through, and very quickly learning what's normal and what's not, which metrics are normal compared to what they've been doing historically over time, and also which metrics are normal compared to how they're doing to each other. So in a situation like this, where load's going down and response time is going up, the Cognition Engine is going to kick in and throw up an anomaly, even though we haven't configured it at all. So sure enough, if I look in the upper right here under our events, you see there's a couple of anomalies that have been started here. And if I click in there, I'll grab the bottom one here. And we see the Cognition Engine, in addition to noticing the data coming through is out of band and figuring out that something's going wrong, it's actually collected all the information from around the entire data set that we've pulled for the customer into one screen to show exactly what's relevant to quickly get to the root cause of this particular problem. So to start off here, we have up here, it tells us exactly what business transaction is going wrong here. So clearly, as an ops organization, I'm gonna care when checkout is going wrong. Right. The second thing it does is it gives me a very clear, concise explanation of why it thinks something's going wrong with checkout. So in this case, it says that average response time is deviating and the 95th percentile response time is deviating. Across the top here, you see it gives me a timeline of the incident. So in this case, we're looking at one that's actually happened in the past. So you can see right around 1:30 a.m., things started to go south and the anomaly was started. And then around 2 a.m., my team got into gear, they saw what was going on, they triggered an action, they took made a change, and the problem was resolved by around 2:04 a.m.
Right, and so this in many ways is a huge sort of inversion in some sense of the user experience we've given in the past.
That's right.
The application topology that we walked through with Whitney earlier is a broad-based view of everything happening in your environment. This is really somehow different. This is much more simplified. Can you talk a little bit about the design and why we ended up with this flow map here?
Sure. So this obviously looks like the flow map that we had on the application screen when we were looking at it at first. But it's different in that, in this case, it's designed specifically to lead you to the root cause of the problem at hand. So, you know, like I said, a typical customer environment will have thousands, hundreds of thousands of tiers or applications potentially. So that flow map can get very dense and very complex. It's useful for seeing the overall picture, but when you know exactly which portion of it is relevant to the task you're trying to take on and the incident you're trying to resolve, it can be extraneous. It can be extra information you don't need. So the cognition engine has actually is showing us, in this case, a version of the flow map that is very simplified. It stripped a lot of the data away. It's showing us only the tiers that are actually connected to this business transaction that is having a problem. And it's showing us the ones that are red, the ones that are the tiers that are showing their own problem. And in this case, it's actually dug down, looked at those, and figured out which of the problems on which tiers are the most likely cause of the overall problems that we're seeing on the BT. So here you see it's almost Google Maps style, drawn me directly to, with its marker, our payment service. And it's saying, hey, the number one most likely cause here is the payment service. And sure enough, if I look over on the left, it's showing me the top two suspected causes, and it's telling me that the checkout BT was probably affected by CPU usage spiking on our payment service, which sounds like a likely culprit. So if I click down in here, it actually gives me more details specifically about this root cause. So it gives me a timeline of when there were problems happening on the payment service specifically. It shows me the metrics on the business transaction that it sees clearly were elevated and out of our normal band range there that caused the anomaly to begin with. And if I scroll down, it shows me a similar metrics that it's seeing on the payment tier in this case that were out of band, again, highly elevated at about the same time, which is how it's decided that this is probably the root cause. And if I keep scrolling down here, it shows me actually which specific nodes in my payment tier are showing the problem. And I could click into those and actually dig down and see more details about that node specifically.
Right, and at AppD over the last many years, you know, one of the things we've always talked about is we want to be the company that gives you the fewest clicks to root cause identification. Mm-hmm. This is really zero clicks to identification, and it's a really big deal in terms of shortening the incident time and getting you to solving the right problem quickly. But what actually I get more excited about here is that if you have the true root cause, as Nancy and I were talking about, then you can start to actually automate the remediation of that cause and not even necessarily have to be involved in that on an incident by incident basis. So can you show us how you take this and actually connect it up to an action?
Sure. So we've had the action engine in AppDynamics for a while. The new cognition engine is now tied directly into it, just like our health rules were before. And in fact, if you look at this incident here, if I collapse these suspected causes, you can see we actually had some actions tied to this incident. And in this case, we took a very light step. We just fired a notification into our Slack channel, so the team gets woken up and can, you know, start the discussion. But the actioning engine can pretty much tie into any process or any backend system you have. So if I show you, just to show you an example here, if I dug into our policies and I wanted to sort of dive into the shallow end of the pool and start simple, I can actually set up a policy that says, whenever the cognition engine finds any problem, no matter what, if it goes critical, I'm gonna go ahead and wire up an action, which in this case just goes ahead and logs a ticket into our ServiceNow installation, right? So very lightweight, we're not deep into the automation there. But the more I know about what's happening and the more I come to trust the cognition engine and start to understand the problems, the more I can start to rely on automation to just solve the problem for me. So for example, let's imagine that in this case, this incident keeps happening again and again, and we're having problems with our payment service. We can't quite figure out what it is, but we do know how to at least solve the temporary problem. I could go back here and instead of just triggering an action on any anomaly, I could get very specific and say, in this case, because I know exactly what's happening here, whenever a health rule violation starts, and that health rule violation is, in this case, for our payment service, it was a CPU problem, and it's only on the payment service I want to do this. I don't want to get too ambitious. So I'll say on our specific tier, in this case, it's our, if I can scroll down, it's our payment service here. Now, because I know exactly what the problem is and we've practiced what the remediation is, I can go and tie, instead of into our ticketing system, I could tie this directly into a script that pokes our Kubernetes system and it increases the container limit, say, on our payment service.
Right, and this is actually something we see a lot of our customers do. We actually consider it a best practice, which is when things go wrong, you know, let us help you automate smarter tickets, right? You can integrate directly into ServiceNow or Jira ticket, into Slack, and bring more of the information you need to get the war room more productive out of the gate. But as you see certain patterns forming, what we see customers doing is for the ones that are more that are happening on a repeated basis, where the remediation is actually a fairly safe automation step, what we see them doing is actually starting to take that step to actually automate the remediation. And just getting back to that point on AI ops, it's not a binary switch that you do automation or you don't do automation. It's a journey that we're all going to be on over the course of the next decade. And we encourage all of you to just start simple and find one or two things that you can automate and then start to add to that over time. Now, you know, as we talked about, the nirvana state here is where most of your things are now automated. And, you know, that's going to be a journey that plays out over the next few years. Let's show folks where we think we end up in this. And let's talk about sort of the eventuality of this journey.
Sure. So, like you said, it's a journey that our customers are on. Yeah. It's a journey that the product's on as well. And we're introducing the Cognition Engine today. Our goal with the Cognition Engine is to get to the point where it can get the information that you need to solve to take an action and decide how to solve the problem, down to the point where it's so small it can fit on the screen of your phone, right? So you don't have to go fire up a browser, get in a war room. You can pull out your phone, see the data, and assuming that it's something you know what to do, you can fire an action directly from there. So I actually have a prototype here of some of the stuff that we're working on. So let me switch over here. This is, you know, imagine you're out walking around in either San Francisco or some European country. I'm not sure where this person is. And you get an alert on your phone, right? Cognition Engine is kicked in and say, hey, an anomaly has started, just like we saw in the demo. I can click on this to get more details of that alert. And sure enough, it's that same key pieces of information that the Cognition Engine has decided exactly why there's a problem and what I need to see. So it's identified a couple metrics that are out of band. And if I drill down into this, it will show me root cause. Again, if I scroll down, here are my checkout metrics versus the metrics on my payment service. And again, if this is something that I know exactly what's going on and we've got the right, you know, action set up, I can go ahead and just, excuse me, click that, and I've got a couple actions to choose from. In this case, I just say, go ahead and restart the server.
Right.
Simple as that.
Great. Thank you so much, Eli, and really excited about the journey ahead. And
yeah.
Thanks. Take care.
My pleasure.
Great. So AppDynamics now is well on its way to becoming a platform that you can rely on for visibility across complex distributed multi-cloud environments, a platform you can rely on for insight to identify root cause of incidents, and a platform that you can count on to start to incrementally take actions to actually remediate the incidents that are forming, ideally before they start to impact your users. Now, over the last decade, AppDynamics has set the bar for APM, and you can count on us over the next decade to set the bar for automation at the app layer.